Hello, how are you? I am Ihani Ruiz Rapport and instructor of mining software RecMin, free license software that geological modeling and mine design, ideal for professionals of geology and mine engineers, mine surveyors, and in this video, I'll teach you how to make a topographic survey of a surface without the need for go to the field or without need topographical equipment such as drones, total stations, or GPS and me. You ask, how do you do that? For two, that you must have Google Earth installed and you must have the program installed RecMin, which is the one I promote. Google will freely download it from internet. There are enough videos, tutorials, then the RecMin program right here on my YouTube channel. You can find that videos. Installation guide or fuse. You go to the website www.recmin.com. There you will see a button that tells you how to install the RecMin program. Do you have tutorial videos in English, in Spanish and Portuguese so you can have this program, which as I say, it's free license, okay? Then let's start Google Earth. What you are going to do is choose a zone, any of a project you want. Do a job of topography, and in this case I will choose this area that I have here on the screen right now, right? Let's make some contours to this part. Remember that if I wanted go to the field because I would have to carry topographic land, move me here, which would generate logistics costs, rents of equipment, etc. So yes, what I need is just a preliminary study. Well, I think what I'll teach in this video is very well how to be able to do something basic of the place. Well, you locate the area under study to take the information. If a polygon, we will nominate the project, project Nieve, correct? We are going to use a polygon here. Bluer, I will only dial the outline, okay, and we will perform the uprising topography in this area that I am selecting right now. Right. And there it is, correct? Then that polygon, he kept it there then, and that will be my zone reference. You can draw more precise, you can make it square, circular, like you want, right? Very well, once you have marked the polygon where you will perform the uprising topographic, click on this button. Add route, right? And later, you're going to go by this part marking points. I'm going to do it this way. The idea is to fill this whole polygon of points. Right. Look what I am doing. Then your previous polygon, it limits you as far as you can draw dots, right? Then I beg your patience, as I tell you, you must use the zoom to locate better points. All marked points would be equivalent to the points captured with a topographic equipment, right? The difference is that here you do it from Google Earth, right? Okay, I think that would be all. A cloud of points, you say okay and it is done, right? Then you have it, your points drawn, okay, and then what are you going to do is, you leave here the layer of points called snow and you order save place as a KML file in a folder. Anybody, in this case, I have a specific folder of a project in RecMin, which is called project, and I'm going to put it on names no right. And then save and ready, it's okay. Then you finish the Google Earth program and then I'll enter this page call www.gpsvisualizer.com/elevation. Okay, I'm leaving you here the description of this video. You will see this interface in this page, and here in this button you go to load the KML file you have saved from Google Earth called Snow KML. Okay, you click on save, and then here in this option you go to choose the option that says TXT format. Then you will click where it says convert and add elevation. Remember that by drawing a cloud of points on Google Earth, the only thing you have registered is the latitude and longitude, but without elevation with this page. So, what are we going to do? Add live to each of the points. Okay, we hope it loads. Ready, already upload the information. Let's show here in this box. Here is the information. You can click here to view in a new window. For example, to see it enlarge, here are all the data, and what you do is copy all this information. With the mouse you select absolutely the whole information. If you realize if the areas with coordinates of all points we draw on Google Earth. Okay, there it is, and then you'll do it. Click on copy and open a notes and paste the information there. Okay, and here is the information. So now you have a text file, and the only thing you do is delete this information here. And that it is useless and not stay. Okay, and also blur information from color. You simply erase and then you save it as a text file in the same project in the same folder, and I'm going to put the names no right. Now you have a TXT file. You tell him to save and you're done. Very well, then minimized all this. Now yes, we entered the RecMin program. We select the project where we are going to import that information. In this case, the Storm project. If you do not know how to add a project to program RecMin, recalls that you can join the free course where I teach that. Here on my page www.somin.pa, you have the option to go to a free course. Here are where you have a course in Spanish, English or Portuguese where taught that and more things to mining professionals. And if you are a geologist or engineer, I recommend you mine. You write to this course. Okay, very well, then once we are in the RecMin program, let's the menu import and choose this option that says import points in TXT format. Okay, the next window does not appear correct. And click here where it says import. Right. Geographical coordinates, because what we're going to care about is that type of coordinates. Recalls that the information that you extract from Google Earth will always be in the system. Topography WGS84 and then no. I know if you noticed the points were in the southern hemisphere. You do not remember? Okay, we close this window, minimizes RecMin, and start again Google Earth for identify that geographic information of the project we are working on. Here it is. We will double click on the project, Snow, and you realize that this information we have saved here, and yes, you realize you are in the area or WHOSO 17 and is in the southern hemisphere. Look, southern hemisphere. Then enter that information and we go again here to import. Now we know what has been that information. Then we mark the southern hemisphere. We click on this button that says read the text file into Z that we have saved with the name Snow. There it is going to load the information, and then click on this button, correct Snow, and here we choose the extension, PTS, correct. Because he has other extensions, but in this case we chose PTS, because it is a file of OK points. We click on save and then here this column that it would be the first. We say not to read it, that is to say the letter T. We are not interested, we just say do not read. We chose this option that says no data, then follow the latitude, choose the latitude, then follow the length, and then follows altitude or elevation. Right. Then we order the program, that is, row does not matter to us. Then we write here 1 and tip the option tabulations, because this information is stored in delimited text by tab. Okay, that's all it's all about. Click import and you're done. This, now if we enter the program, RecMin to drawing module. Here is the RecMin program for those who do not know it is software, very intuitive and practical, us. Let's go to the general panel and come here. Where is it? These buttons where we can open the different types of files with which the RecMin works and we choose. Open point files. And here is the files now we select and tell him to open. And here is the information that we draw on Google Earth. You can change color and those things. You go to this button, list of objects here, change the width, for example, let's change it to 2. Here you can change the color if you want and continue, and it's already okay. Very well, if you want to save those changes, click on this button and save it there. Snow, PTS, okay, very well. After this we go here, this menu that is called Settlin T3, and we chose the option that says triangular points. We click and choose the group here, points, and simply click on triangular, and we waited. That takes depending on the amount of points, in this case, for example, did so fast. Okay, at the end of triangular it would seem that everything is hidden. You just go to this button that says list of objects turns off points, continue, and click on the button that says recalculate limits, and there is another time information. Forgive me, I had to pay more points. So we activate a T3 and we go here to points and we turn off the points, right? And I give recalculate boundaries, and there it is. Okay, what we see here is the topography that was in the Google Earth. Then let's draw the curves. Level, and that is already easy. You go to the Settlin T3 menu and choose to generate isolines of T3 active, but before that we have check the difference of dimensions that there are in this topography and the difference of quotas. If you realize it's 300 meters, that's does with right mouse click. Okay, you return to the plane. Plant, you go back to the menu. Settlin T3/generate isolines of T3 active. Here you choose option 1. What do you want the program to say? Make the curves in the any plane. Okay, and here we are going to say that every 5 meters draw a level curve. I click accept, 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 and here I click where it says yes, and they start to draw the contours of that topography. Okay, how do you realize? You needed to go to the ground. You only had to do what I taught you in this video, right? There, it's fine. I can change my name, for example, Snow, and if I want, can save in a separate file with its own format. RecMin will be saved with SU format. I say save it, and that's okay, very good. Then these contours, if I want, you can export them back to Google Earth, can be used to see if they are the contours I wanted. It's easy to click here on the list of surfaces, right click and choose this option that says to generate KML file in coordinates of vitreous 89, which is equal to topographic system WGS 84. And I give him a name. I'll put Univisilinius. Right. Do you realize that you're going to save in KML format? Then the program asked me what, who so belongs to, or in which zone. Remember that it was zone 17 and the Southern Hemisphere, right? Click on accept, and here the program asks me if level curves I want glued to the mat, or I want that retain the quota. Then I say option 1, accept, okay. And you're done. Realize that the information automatically is generated. And I want you to see now that you have it there, the contours. Okay, we just turn off the guideline of root, and there you have the curves. We can also turn off the polygon and look what we have achieved without going to the physically. We have achieved curves only using Google Earth and the RecMin program, right? Very well. Then in this video I taught you how to extract contour lines from Google Earth with help from RecMin, and this from GPS VISUALIZER. Comment in the next video, I'll show you how to bring the satellite image of Google Earth, cut it and bring it to RecMin 4. You can see it here in 3D and see the satellite image here. Okay, so that'll teach you in the following video very well. Remember then, below has a link to join a free course, and you can implement the RecMin in your mining project. Okay, well, see you in the next video.